Carter Sports back, and your boy about to go in. Y'all see the title, No Sunshine Pumping. Let's go! What's up, y'all? For y'all who been following me, y'all know I've been going in lately on these defensive linemen, recruits that SC has been targeting in the high school ranks and in the transfer portal ranks, right? So while I'm following these stories, I'm on these kids, I'm trying to bring y'all what we need, show y'all what we need and what's out there. I come across them, I have already seen it, but didn't pay too much into it. But one of our defensive linemen who committed to us, I say about like 3-4 months ago, David Pele Pele, or David Pale Pale, excuse me if I'm mispronouncing his name. He's one of our defensive line recruits, our only one that plays with his hand in his ground. We got the great Cam Fountain and Mama KC Crawford. Don't we all love Mama Crawford, right? But Cam, he a rush edge. He a rush edge. David was the only down lineman we had in his class. So David got kicked off his high school team. And I'm thinking about, like, why did he get kicked off his high school team? I hope he didn't do nothing, you know, get in trouble with no laws. You know what I'm saying? I hope he didn't make a mistake that's you can't bounce back from. But I hear it was a social media mistake. It was a social media mistake. He got on social media and said his team sucked. And basically, they need a new head coach. Like, where a head coach at? So he got on social media. He kind of threw his teammates under the bus, even though when you keeping it real, sometimes that's the casualty of keeping it real. So he felt the need to keep it real on social media, which he probably shouldn't, being an athlete, especially a high school athlete, you know, one of them top prospects. So I can understand the high school football team, like, yeah, we gonna sit you down. You kind of, you know, betrayed your brothers. This could have been an in-house conversation, I guess. So I could see the high school team doing what they did. Then later, I find out that Scott Schrader say that USC is no longer going to offer this kid a scholarship. Like, he ain't got no spot at USC no more. And I'm like, that don't make no damn sense. This kid been committed for 4 months. You should know this kid. You should have knew him before you offered the scholarship. And then you shouldn't offer a scholarship to a kid to where you feel he ain't a good kid, that he could be a pariah or a locker room cancer or a kid that's not maturing the right way. If you offer him this scholarship, obviously you thought he was a good kid. So how does him making one mistake on social media constitute you for pulling your scholarship? Now, it's true, you got a right to offer whoever you want to. It's not a right, it's a privilege to be offered. But when you USC, it ain't like we got 6 or 7 defensive linemen committed. We have no defensive linemen committed. We don't have the luxury to play hardball and look for perfect kids right now who didn't make no mistakes in their life. We ain't in that position. We don't have the luxury to be picky with defensive linemen, especially if they could play and they ain't committing no crimes. They ain't no criminal, man. He made a simple social media mistake. He a kid. He gonna do that. USC is not in the position to even withdraw an offer from a defensive lineman. Last year, we got 3 defensive linemen. In my opinion, in every class, it should at least be 5. Should at least, to tell you the truth, it should at least be 6. We got 3 last year. Now we on the verge of having none this year. So, unless in the next, couple of weeks, unless we snatch 5 or 6 defense alignment, because we only snatched 3 last year. So this year we supposed to made up 4 and snatch like 7. If we don't snatch up like 4 or 5 defense alignments before December 20th, which is less than 30 days, and we ain't even got a defensive coordinator, we ain't announced the coordinator yet. If we end this recruiting cycle with no defense alignment, it don't matter what defensive coordinator we get. Our defense gonna suck. You can't depend on the transfer portal. Not like that. Not like that. You use the transfer portal for depth. You can't use the transfer portal for your whole defensive line. It ain't gonna be a Bear Alexander every year, somebody in the transfer portal that's a good player that played enough last the year before so you could watch his film and say, okay, he ready. He already, before he come here, he's making an impact. He's already a plus player. He's not just potential. See, Bear Alexander, he just wasn't potential. He actually showed it on the field. Anthony Lucas was just potential. And you see, he struggled to find his way. I feel like they shouldn't have dropped Anthony Lucas to 260. He came in at USC at 280, but that's a whole nother different story, right? That was that Grinch speed D, right? But what I'm saying is USC ain't got the luxury, man. We can't end up with only three defensive linemen in the last two recruiting class. Lincoln Riley, get your shit together. What is wrong? It ain't gonna matter what defensive coordinator we got. So it's Carter Sports, man. It's Carter Sports, and I'm gonna let y'all know the real. I'm not gonna sunshine pump. I'm not gonna sunshine pump. See, when I started to make these YouTube videos, I had a choice to make. I had a choice to make. Either I could sunshine pump or keep it real. I know sunshine pumps got its pros and cons. I know keeping it real got pros and cons, but I chose to keep it real instead of sunshine pump. And what I'm looking at, this recruiting is horrible. Right now, as of today, if the recruiting period ended, right now, as of today, USC will only be signed three defensive linemen in the last two recruiting cycles. And they got the nerve to let a kid go because he made a mistake on social media? How bad do USC want Lincoln Riley to me? Like, I do not want to bash Lincoln Riley. I don't. But why does every decision I see, everything I hear about USC is the wrong decision being made? Everything I hear about USC, y'all doing the opposite to show that y'all really care about winning. They do the opposite. I hear this Jim Leonard thing being held up because USC don't know if they want to let him hire his own assistants because Lincoln Riley want to keep playing buddies. I hope that ain't true, but that's what I'm hearing. And then, 2 days ago, in the Los Angeles Coliseum, a high school football game was played. And out this whole year, it probably ain't been this much talent on the football field. That's the most talent all year that's been on a high school football field besides when them teams played each other earlier in the season. And you don't show your face. And this is your house. This is a Coliseum. This is where you say gonna be the mecca of football. And you can't even show your face. Anything short of Lincoln Riley was at a meeting with Jim Leonard, ironing out the details of his contract, that's the only excuse that should be acceptable. Anything else, kill yourself. Because we killing our own self. We killing our own self. It's embarrassing to see modern day kids after the football game saying, always dreamed to play for USC in the end of my high school career, playing in this stadium, man, it's just cool, but they ain't even going to USC. That means USC is hurting themselves. That means USC is the problem. If you can't secure a commitment from a kid who has dreamed, a local kid who has dreamed to go to the very school that you coach at, and you can't secure a commitment from a kid
who have dreamed to play at USC, kill yourself. Because that's what you're doing to the program. Obviously, you're doing something wrong. How can Georgia, Oregon, how can they get kids who dream to play for USC? That means they offering something that you can offer, but you choose not to. And I'm sick of it. I'm sick. Because the most simplest things that should be obvious that a program and a coach should do, we refuse to do. It's sad, man. It's sad, man. We killing ourselves. Sometimes I feel like, was Lincoln Riley and Grinch, was they sent to destroy USC even more? It feel like it. USC feel like the U.S. government intentionally trying to crash the economy. It seems like they intentionally trying to crash USC and get paid while doing it.
Man, I just don't get it, man. And you know what? And I ain't gonna have a heart attack. My blood pressure rising. My head starting to hurt, man. Say I'm waking up the neighborhood. So I'm just let y'all know, man, yours truly, like, I hope that one day, you know, Lincoln Riley, he's still a young coach, man. So hopefully he realizes his flaws and his errors. And we can have a great head coach. But right now, the dude seemed like he can't make the right decisions off the field. Could somebody convince me that he the right leader? Besides calling plays and coaching quarterback, can somebody convince me that he could do everything else it takes to build a championship program? Because I don't see it. We got zero defensive linemen. I wouldn't give a damn if USC didn't pay high school recruits. If I'm Lincoln Riley, I'm digging in my own pocket, then I got paid $100 million. Ain't no way in hell I'm gonna be sitting in December with no defensive lineman committed to my university. Hey, you might as well pack it up. I'm telling y'all, and I'm gonna leave with this. If we end up with only three defensive linemen in the last two recruiting periods, it don't matter what defensive coordinator we get. We gonna suck. And they gonna try to get out of there because the players we got gonna make them look bad. And ain't no another team or NFL team gonna wanna hear the players wasn't good enough at USC. So we can forget about it. We can forget about it. That's probably why this culture search is taking so long, because the culture's like, well, I need something to work with. And the last two seasons, you ain't even got no defensive linemen. That's where it all started. You ain't even got none. So I'm gonna leave y'all with that, man. That is some food for thought for y'all, man. Feel free to convince me in the comments that Lincoln Riley is a great leader, because at this point, all the decisions he made off the field, I ain't digging, and I ain't digging none of them. Every time I hear something about this dude, it makes me sick. Because it's like, why are you doing that? Still talking about, he gonna say something like, we four plays away from being 10-1. No, we were four plays away from being 1-10. And a 10-1 team ain't gonna be four plays away for being 7-5. A 10-1 team ain't gonna even put themselves in position to be getting beat by one or two plays. They ain't gonna put themselves in that position. They not. They not at all. So I'm gonna leave y'all with that, man. It's Carter Sports. I had to rant because this is getting on my nerves. I'm looking at our recruiting class now. We got, and what Scott Schrader's reporting true, we got no defensive linemen. And that's all I've been making videos on. Like, what are we doing? But until then, y'all, hopefully next time I hop on here. Hopefully I'll be able to give y'all some good news, man.
I'll be able to give y'all some good news. But right now, I still feel like Lincoln Riley still don't get it. But until then, it's Carter Sports. Let's go.